an area where this kind of practice that isn't resolved, because I think that's generated from more conversation. And it's something that I'm working through at a particularly gnarly point in my PhD. But this kind of practice, I think, really treads this dual horizon. It sort of has a capacity to communicate on two levels, to participants and to spectators, through this mediating term, the photograph. So it has, there's risks, though, I think, with situating something between these two practices, and that's diluting the value of both of them. So diluting that charismatic agency of documentary photography, the ability of the image to catalyse social change, and really draw an audience into a primary experience. So, you know, we end up then with tokenistic collaboration of participants, and the photographer can claim co-authorship, and that happens very commonly. That allows to retain a visual aesthetic that is acceptable to the photo world, or an outcome that lacks charismatic agency and is really unable to use those platforms of advocacy that are really nicely built into documentary photography. I think collaborative projects are a really great way of visualising new ways of approaching these alternatives to the kind of either. But that's probably well and truly on top.